those Christmas cookies, sugar.
How perfect. And the holidays just aren't complete without an oven full of fresh baked Christmas cookies, right? But how about cookies with a royal touch? Well, fortunately, the founder of Southern Baked Pie Company in Gainesville also knows a thing or two about baking some decadent cookies. UGA grad Amanda Wilbanks joins us now with her special recipe for Christmas cookies with royal icing.
Yes. So what I love about these cookies is they're not overly sweet, and we're tossing it up. So rather than making a sugar cookie pie or a sugar cookie, we're going to make one for my cookbook using pie crust.
Gotcha.
So what we want to first do is we want to start with our flour. Add in your flour. This is 2.5 cups of flour. Okay. Butter. You can't go wrong with butter.
Yes. I read where you love all butter crust, all butter all the time, the real thing,
all butter all the time. No need for margarine or the fake stuff. So what I then added in was a teaspoon of sugar, a teaspoon of salt, and what you're going to do is work this together until your butter turns into pea-sized pieces.
Okay.
And once you've got that, use a pastry cutter to do that. Add in your water. The key, people often come, all of our customers will come into our pie shop, Southern Baked, and say, what makes your pie crust so good? And what it is we do it by hand, and we don't add too much water, which keeps it from getting tough. So that's one of the keys. So you want to keep working that together until your dough begins to form into a ball.
Okay.
And then take your dough, push it together really good. It'll turn into a ball like this. Wrap it in saran wrap, and then we're going to chill it in the fridge for an hour.
Okay.
And that also keeps it from turning into a tough dough. So you want to make sure to let it rest.
No tough dough.
All right. You want buttery, flaky, light dough and buttery, flaky, light Christmas cookies. So I don't know about you, but I don't like to make a big mess in my kitchen and flour the whole place.
Mm-hmm.
So put your dough, after you take it out of the fridge, between two pieces of parchment, and then you want to roll your dough from the inside
out
the edges.
Oh, it's like, why did I think of that? That
genius?
Is so basic.
It's basic, but it's genius, and it helps with cleanup at the end, because we all know mom's always in charge of cleanup.
Absolutely.
And it's nice not to have a mess. So after you've rolled your dough out, pull off your parchment, get your favorite cookie cutters. I know I have some copper ones that my grandmother passed down to me.
Oh, what a nice tradition.
Isn't that a sweet tradition? So every time I make cookies each year, it reminds me of her. But what we want to do, I brought my plastic ones today, just cut out your shapes if you want to cut out one and push it in here.
And I know you said it was your mother, your grandmother. This was a tradition of cooking, right?
It was. I grew up learning to cook with my grandmother and my mother. So anytime I'm in the kitchen, especially at the holidays, it reminds me of them.
Nice.
It makes me feel close. So always prick your pie crust cookies right here so that they don't turn, they don't get too fluffy and rise up.
Oh, that keeps the little bubble.
The air bubble.
Clearly,
out.
I'm not a professional baker.
That's
right?
Okay.
The little puffy thing that happens.
The
right.
Puffy thing in the middle. We'll
prick
call it
to keep the puffy
thing
to go away.
So then what we're going to do is we're going to pop the cookies in the oven and bake them for 15 minutes, and you're going to get these nice golden brown cookies that come out. And while your cookies are cooling, you're going to prepare your royal icing.
Okay.
So royal icing is simple. You're just whipping egg whites until they're nice and frothy, and then adding in your sugar, your powdered sugar, and getting it to the consistency you want. You don't want it too runny or too thick.
Right, right.
You just get it to your desired consistency. I love these right here. They're perfect for kids. That way it doesn't splatter out the end of the popping bag.
Yes.
And then you just grab your kids, get them in the kitchen, or you do it for fun yourself, which is always nice to have a little break
indeed.
And decorate. And you decorate your cookies. Add some sprinkles to add some holiday cheer. And at the end, you come out with these beautiful cookies that are light and airy and not overly sweet.
Mm.
And I did speak to Santa this morning, and he said that these are Santa approved. So this would be perfect for Christmas.
So this is what we need to work on.
This is what we need to work on. That's right.
Fantastic.
Thank
All right.
You.
Amanda Wilbanks, thank you so much. And for
thank
more
you.
Information on today's recipes for Southern Baked Pie Company, go to fox5atlanta.com and look for the viewer information story. Coming up next, take a